one again on my phone. Actually, can you hold this for me? It's so distracting. Does that seem familiar to anybody here? So my work for several years has been promoting the idea that there are lots of playful opportunities for learning and teaching in the seemingly mundane activity of young people just walking around their neighborhoods or biking around their communities, especially now that their technologies, most of them, are mobile. And then something really interesting happened this year. This very point got national news and became a national conversation when a couple of software engineers from San Francisco developed and released a mobile game. Does anybody want to guess what that game is? Pokemon Go, thank you. And I think I've got another hand about to raise. How many people play in this room? Okay. And how many people have young people in your lives that play? All right. So I get to answer yes to both of those questions as well. But what is it about this technology that is so interesting, that is so engaging, that has so many people, actually so many parents, actually wanting their kids to play? Strange idea, right? Well, first of all, it sounds simple. It's mobile. You have to be moving around to play the game. You have to leave the couch, the bag of chips, the TV behind. And actually, the more you walk around, the more area you cover, the more engaging the game becomes. And you actually get rewarded for that mobility. Secondly, the technology is place-based. It's using the GPS affordances in your smart device, your phone, your tablet, to precisely locate you in time and space. This means the game can actually give you feedback about a place that might be already very familiar to you, your neighborhood or your community. It can say, hey, did you realize this tree that you pass by going to work every day is 200 years old and has a sister sibling in Japan? Not that that's happened to me. Or that there's a bench outside of your community center that was dedicated to a really famous resident that lived in this place that you didn't even know about. So it's actually remediating your experience of a very familiar place. That means playing the game outside in Manhattan, for instance, is very different than playing outside the doors of the Seattle Center, right? But there's kind of a darker assumption that the technology does too, and that is there are certain neighborhoods, certain communities in your city that are more engaging to play in than others. And that's where mobile city science comes in. Mobile city science assumes that every neighborhood is rich with learning opportunities. Mobile city science gives young people a six-week intensive experience to learn digital literacies that are emerging alongside these place-based mobile technologies. It gives them a chance to collect and produce original information, original data about their neighborhoods, to then analyze and then create new representations of their neighborhood that can also live on a mobile device. And these representations are called countermaps. So countermaps can live just like Pokemon Go lives on your phone, and it can show adults, so anybody else, a couple of things. First, it says, hey, from a young person perspective, these are some really important things to me about my neighborhood. I think these are really cool. Secondly, it can show you that there are some aspects of the neighborhood that they wish were there that aren't on the ground but now live in this digital platform. For example, something as simple as a grocery store to walk to, or a protected bike lane so they can get to school easily, or a public library that we're just a little bit closer. So countermaps can now be in the hands of that public school teacher in your neighborhood who wants to create a curricular design that is place-based and might actually address some community-level issues and engage kids around something that they thought was super interesting. Or that transportation engineer who's trying to develop a new light rail station, right? Or a public or urban planner. So now the expertise has shifted, and adults are walking around rather than having their mobile devices populated by monsters or cool things that the technology assumes you should know about. Now your experience is populated by youth-relevant cultural assets that are rich with learning potential. So my final pitch to you is, while these technologies are great for playing around, Let's also turn these same technological affordances over to young people and let them show us the underutilized resources in their own neighborhoods that are rich for teaching and learning designs. Thank you.